而家我哋嚟睇下第四题啦，即系呢个试卷最尾一题，都系25分嘅，section B 啊。佢同时都系冇 spreadsheet，咁就可能冇咁多计算啦，计数嘅题目。我哋净系有一个 exhibit，同埋一个 requirement，我哋有两个 A 同 B 啊。B 佢自己都有一啲比较散啲嘅啦。有三个六分、六分、六分喺呢度有 professional marks for climate related issues，咁佢又冇讲系 part A 或者系 part B 啦，咁我就觉得呢个2分其实系属于系成个题目嘅23分入边俾到你一个 professional marks two marks，咁点样可以攞到呢啲 professional marks 咧？其实又唔系咁艰难嘅，只需要你当你喺作答嗰阵时写个答案。解釋得好清楚，啲意思唔會好含糊，同埋你嘅 order 咧係放得比較順啲嘅，咁人哋會明白你喺度講緊啲咩嘢咧。咁基本上最少1分你都已經係攞到手咗噶啦。如果真係寫得咁好咧，你可以攞到第1分啦、2分。咁如果我哋睇requirement A 咧，呢個5分啊，佢係需要。睇任何嘅 exhibit 嘅，咁呢個 exhibit one 咧，似乎係 for part B 嘅啫啦。咁啊，requirement A 咧就有自己嘅一個古仔，同埋個 requirement 咧係 discuss the validity of the above opinion expressed by mostly these people are accountant preparer of financial statement，佢哋就係嗰啲會計師啦，佢哋就係去做呢個財政報告嘅。咁佢哋講咩咧？睇下上高啊。Many preparer feels that is already sufficient disclosure of climate-related matters in the management commentary, and there's no need to disclose anything else in the actual financial statement, especially there's no impact on those financial statement. 哦，咁呢啲 preparer 又覺得咧，我已經喺 management commentary 嗰度已經講咗有關於 climate change 嘅嘢噶啦，咁喺financial statement 入边咧，我系唔需要再提及到嘅。咁我哋就真系要好好地倾下一样嘢啦。佢其实又唔系话你喺 management commentary 嗰度讲咗之后，喺 financial statement 系唔需要讲嘅。咁其实我哋冇呢啲咁样嘅条例啦。仲有就系、是，其实有几多个人去睇嗰个 management commentary 咧，我哋就真系唔知道啦。咁喺呢个比较普遍啲嘅投资者嘅。在眼中咧，financial statement 呢個財政報告咧，依然係有個好重要嘅角色啦。咁 management commentary 咧，就真係唔係個個人都會睇啦。但係 financial statement 咧，就真係可能個個都會睇，佢會睇一啲profit 啊、cash flow 啊，同埋一啲啲關於 dividend 嘅信息啊。如果有啲想知多啲嘅，咁佢哋依然係會首選佢哋嘅 financial statement 啦。management commentary 都有人睇，但應該係冇咁多，冇好似 financial statement 咁多人睇啦。Even though there is an acceptance that investors feel that such info is important, some preparers think that the materiality decision does not extend to climate change because there's no advice on the dealing with the subject. 咁佢哋覺得佢係好重要，但係因為 advice 冇講到，咁我哋就唔需要放落去 financial statement 嗰度啦。我又唔可以話呢個係一個錯嘅 statement 嚟嘅。咁如果會計師覺得 IFRS 冇提到，我就唔需要放喺 financial statement 咧。咁即係呢個會計師佢嘅注重 minimum disclosure。咁只需要我達到個條例所需要嘅 IFRS 需要嘅companies law 需要嘅，咁就得噶啦。唔可以話錯，因為如果係嗰個 auditor 嚟入嚟咧，佢睇到咧，佢都係會俾你 true and fair view 嘅。因為其實真係真嘅嘛，我係跟足咗晒所有嘅條例，你又唔可以話我做錯嘢。佢就係冇做錯嘢，但係如果我哋係諗到你唔好跟 law 嚟講啦，你係用一個 principle base 嘅 judgment 嚟講咧，其實你需要放埋個 climate change 噶啦。點解咧？因為呢條啦嘛，個投資者話需要啦嘛，咁咪需要咯。因為你做呢個 financial statement 係俾佢哋睇噶嘛，如果佢覺得需要。你真係要俾佢哋知咯，因為你唔好忘記啊，喺 conceptual framework 入邊咧，the objective of financial reporting is to provide information。 做 user 或 financial statement。咁我哋唔系做俾自己嘅，我做俾佢哋，做俾啲投资者睇嘅。咁投资者想睇乜嘢咧，我哋就放乜嘢俾佢哋睇啦。咁另一个 point 咧，点解 climate change 虽然 IFRS 冇提及到，诶，我哋觉得有嗰个必要放喺 financial statement 咧，因为 climate change 系好严重下噶。咩系 climate change 咧？我哋系讲紧可能个环境嘅变化、气候嘅变化。咁喺一啲比较先进啲嘅国家啦，尤其是系响呢个欧盟入边咧，EU 入边咧，佢哋系领先全球嘅。佢哋有好多呢啲咁样嘅 climate change measurements。可能佢又话你如果你嘅车，譬如话你嘅车啊，系仲系打紧电油啊，你系唔可以响 EU 买噶啦以后，因为 EU 净系可以接受 electric car。我佢哋系想减少呢啲废气嘅排量啊，佢哋有做呢啲咁样嘅嘢。咁如果我系做车嘅，我系做啲电油嘅车嘅，咁我就好麻烦咯，因为 EU 嗰度系唔收我啲车噶啦，咁佢直接都影响到我公司噶喎。佢同个 CSR 有少少唔一样嘅，CSR 系一个 voluntary action。如果你冇做 CSR，你会有问题嘅，你公司人会执笠嘅。你唔同啲熊猫影相咧，你系会执笠嘅。但系呢个 climate change 有少少唔同，佢系 model 的 government regulation change。如果政府 ban 你嘅产品嘅话咧，ban 你嘅 services 嘅话咧，咁你就真系好大剂噶啦。咁佢除咗会带嚟 impairment 之外咧，佢可能仲会影响到公司嘅生存，会个 threatening the going concern status of a company。咁大剂，唔通你唔想将啲呢啲咁样嘅 climate change information 放落去 financial statement 咩？嗱，佢又只系得5分啫啦吓。如果你睇睇我嘅答案咧，那个 suggested answer 咧，我系有提及到乜嘢系 materiality 啦，因为啲会计师就觉得佢其实唔属于 materiality level 嘅 consideration 入边嘅，因为 IFRS 冇提及到嘅。但系我哋系冇讲到information 系 material if IFRS talks about it，我哋唔系咁样讲喎，我哋就系话 information 系 material if they can affect the decision of the use of financial statement。你嘅 IFRS 有提及到或者冇提及到，其实都唔系一个我哋考虑嘅因素。我哋只系睇呢个 information 究竟会唔会影响到投资者嘅决定。如果会咧，佢就系 material information 啦。So IFRS not dealing with climate change, but that is because they cannot react fast enough。咁要改一改一个 IFRS 咧，或者系需要做一个新嘅 IFRS 咧，其实真系好食时间下嘅。佢可以係可能喺1年入邊啊，或者2年入邊做成，亦都可能超過10年都做唔出嚟嘅。咁你都會明白啦，喺 IASB 嗰度嘅 International Accounting Standard Board，其實佢哋係好忙嘅，可能人手都唔夠，可能經費都唔夠，所以佢哋唔可以咁快可以做出一啲新嘢出嚟。咁 climate change 咧係新嘢啊，好多政府都開始睇睇呢啲咁嘅事，改一改佢哋嘅法律。去應對呢個 climate change measurement，咁 IFRS 就冇辦法咁快可以出到一啲啲咁樣嘅嘢啦。咁你身為一個會計師，佢未出，咁你都可以改住先噶嘛。因為to achieve a true and fair view，我哋唔一定要跟 IFRS，我哋其實可以做更多更好嘅嘢俾我哋嘅投資者。So climate change can affect a business in many ways。最直接嘅咧就係 change in government regulation，係最快嘅。佢一改一改一個條例，改一改一個法律，你就中招噶啦。咁啊，impairment 啊，threatening going concern 啊，会发生嘅。咁如果系咁大剂咧，我就觉得我哋系需要放入去啦。喺呢个 financial statement 考虑下一个 section，讲一啲啲关于 climate change 嘅嘢嘅。第四条问题 part A 咧，个考官咧就冇提及到啲考生有啲乜嘢特别嘅弱点啦。基本上考官都非常之满意一啲考生嘅答案啦。good answer 啦，呢度 good 啦，嗰度 good 啦，就冇乜嘢大问题需要去 highlight 噶啦。咁完成咗 part A 之后咧，我哋就睇下 part B，我哋需要做啲乜嘢啦。咁 part B 咧，佢有三个细部分啦，我有一个部分系6分嘅。Discuss the potential effect of climate-related matters。 有个公司名响呢度咧，我哋会睇下个 exhibit 入边究竟讲紧啲乜嘢嘢啦。For the year, current year，咁我哋嘅答案咧就会专注响呢一年入边。咁我哋有冇机会提及到2017年之后嘅事咧？咁要睇情况啦。如果佢 exhibit 入边冇提到咧，我哋系唔需要去提嘅，因为个 requirement 咧系讲得好明嘅，我哋系需要讲 for the current year 2017年嘅年份。IFRS、PPE 同埋呢个 intangible assets，咁我哋做呢个先啦，六分啦。其实 climate related matters 咧，佢系会影响到好多嘢，系好全面嘅嘢嚟嘅。咁如果你讲到 PPE、intangible assets，佢又会同时提及到 impairment，因为如果有一啲坏消息啊，除咗个 PPE，可能佢嘅 useful life 会短啲。咁我哋其实都需要做一个 impairment test，但系你要小心啊！如果咁样作答嘅话，佢系有分 point one、point two 同 point three 啦。我哋系需要，当我哋提及到呢个 first point 咧，我哋最好就唔好讲提及到 impairment 嘅事啦。咁讲紧 impairment 咧，我哋最好又唔好提及到 provision 嘅事啦。我自己本身就唔系好中意呢啲咁样嘅分类啦。咁样佢会限制我做答案作答，因为 climate issue 其实真系好全面嘅嘢嚟嘅。咁另外一个问题就系，如果你唔小心响 point one 提及到 impairment 嘅事，咁响 point two 你就冇嘢讲啦。咁你选择唔要讲，因为你觉得我响 point one 已经提及到 impairment 啦，我 point two 唔要再提及 impairment，咁我直头去 point three 讲 provision，究竟可唔可以咧？呢个咧，如果系 law by law 嚟讲咧，系跟住嗰个条例嚟讲咧，你系攞唔到分数嘅，因为你系需要响 point two 讲 impairment 嘅事。但系如果系咁样嘅情形咧，实质上嗰个 marker 睇到你嘅答案嗰阵时咧，通常佢哋系会俾你分数嘅。但系我哋就劝啲考生唔好搏啦，佢讲明咗要 one two three，你就最好跟住系 one two three 啦。咁我睇睇个 exhibit 先啦。呢个 exhibit 比较长啲嘅，咁我哋首先要针对咧就系 PPE 同埋 intangible asset 啦。如果你未读嘅话咧，你其实系可以 pause up pause 个 video 睇一睇个 exhibit 先再翻翻嚟嘅。咁我哋发觉到喺呢个 exhibit 入边咧，佢提及到 PPE 系几散下嘅，喺唔同嘅 paragraph 入边咧，佢都会提及到嘅。譬如话喺第一个 paragraph 啦。佢首先係講到佢嘅生意係點樣嘅啦，佢哋係 energy company 啦，係用啲煤炭去發電嘅。咁呢啲嘢咧，其實對環境非常會造成污染啦。咁喺好多個國家咧，係鼓勵你用呢啲咁樣嘅 energy 噶啦。如果你再繼續用咧，你可能會被罰款。如果你被罰款嘅話咧，咁你就需要將呢啲罰款轉嫁落消費者身上，咁你嗰啲 power 你就會買得比較貴啲啦。當你買得比較貴啲咧，你可能會客户流失啦，你就會賺錢啦，會係一啲比較全面啲嘅影響嘅。咁 PPE 嚟講咧，佢哋首先響呢個 the end of the second paragraph 就有提到佢要 improve 佢嘅 existing building。improvement 係 enhancement，咁你使錢去 improve 你嘅 building 咧，呢啲。其实是 PPE 嚟嘅，佢哋唔系 expenses 嚟嘅。如果你使钱去 maintain the building 咧，咁嗰啲就系 expenses 啦。improving 咧，咁呢啲系 PPE 嚟嘅。咁样我可以喺我嘅答案里边提及到，佢嘅 PPE 咧系会增加嘅，向2017年啦，今年啦会增加嘅。咁嗰个 intangible asset 咧，其实都系有增加嘅，因为佢哋要做呢个R&D 啦。我知道 research 其實係 expenses 啦，development 先正係 intangible asset，但係你都會增加啦，你嘅 intangible asset。OK，咁除咗呢一點之外咧，我哋係睇到嘅係有一個 physical damage 啊，係喺 second paragraph 嘅呢度，因為係環境嘅變化呢、這個同。个法律冇咩关系噶啦，weather extremes 环境天气气候嘅变化啦， 咁呢啲就會影響到我哋嘅 PP 嘅 physical 啦，就會有更加多嘅 damage。咁如果有 damage 嘅話咧，可能佢嘅壽命會更短，會影響到我哋嘅 useful life，同埋佢嘅 decommissioning 會係提早嘅。可能想當初我哋買呢個 PPE 嗰陣時咧，我哋諗住可以用10年，但係用開4年之後咧，因為氣候嘅變化，我哋發覺我哋其實唔可以用到10年嘅，可能喺第7年或者係第8年咧，我哋就需要將佢拆除啦。咁拆除嗰陣時咧，我哋就需要使一啲錢啦。咁10年前咧，或者係5年前咧，當我哋買呢個 PP 嗰陣時咧，我哋有一個 provision for decommissioning，我哋 credit to provision liability and debit to the PP。咁依家如果我哋係要比預計更早去拆除呢個 power plant 嚟講咧，我哋係需要重新去估計我哋嘅 provision 嘅數字嘅。咁如果我哋改一改個 provision 咧，佢又會直接影響到個 PPE 喎，因為你唔好唔記得啊。想當初我哋recognize 個 provision 嗰陣時咧，我哋係 credit provision liability and debit to the PPE。咁依家你改 provision 係你係需要改埋嗰個 PPE，咁佢又會影響到你嘅 depreciation，影響到你嘅 use life，影響到你嘅 depreciation 嘅喎。咁樣仲有啲乜嘢嘢咧？暫時係冇啦。如果你睇睇我嘅答案咧，呢、这個6分咧，我哋又可以攞到嘅。capital expenditure increase because of this and that，我哋講個理由之後，你就會 increase in depreciation and amortization。咁你嘅 research cost 咧都會 increase 嘅 expenses 嘅。physical harm 你就會有一個 provision 嘅重新估計啦，影響到 carrying amount useful life to be shorter，then 你又會 higher depreciation。仲有，如果有啲咁嘅事情發生咧，你係好需要去做一個全面性嘅評估啦，睇下你其他嘅 PPE 同埋 intangible asset 係冇受到影響嘅，你嘅 useful life 啊，嘅 scrap value 啊，如果係需要嘅話，你係需要作出更改嘅啦。咁如果我哋睇下第二部分咧，又係有6分去討論呢個 IAS 36 impairment of assets。咁翻翻去嗰個 exhibits 嗰度咧，我哋知道如果有 impairment indicators，即係話有啲壞消息啦，咁個公司咧其實係需要做呢個 impairment testing 嘅。咁 test 完之後咧，係咪真係有 impairment loss 咧？又真係未知嘅，需要 test 咗先知道。咁點樣 test 咧？我哋會將嗰個asset 嘅 carrying amount 去 match 佢嘅 recoverable amount。咁 recoverable amount 咧就係 the higher of value in use and is very very less cost of disposal。咁究竟用比较值钱啦，定系卖比较值钱？咁如果用比较值钱咧，我哋系会用嗰个去利用嘅价值去衡量，去 match 个 carrying amount。如果你觉得卖比较值钱咧，咁我哋就会用嗰个 fair value 去 match 嗰个 carrying amount。如果个 recovery amount 系高嘅，系高过嗰个 asset carrying amount，咁就冇 losses 啦。但系如果个 recovery 好好低，唔值钱，咁就有会个 impairment loss 啦。首先我哋要睇下响呢个咁样嘅情形有冇 impairment indicators 啦。个答案系有嘅。OK，首先佢有 reducing sales demand。等我揾下佢啊。OK，decline in the demand。如果你有 decline in sales demand 咧，咁好大可能你系搵唔够钱，你嘅 value in use 系会低嘅。咁如果你搵唔够钱，就冇钱去 recover 去冚嗰個 asset 嘅 carrying amount 啦，咁你好可能你嘅 asset 系会有 impairment loss 嘅。咁另外一个 indicator 咧就系、supply chain is getting more complex，可能你运输上会出现问题。咁佢哋系做电噶啦，运输电咧好多时候系会有 energy losses 嘅，咁样再加上呢个气候嘅转变啦。可能會影響到你嘅 power transmission，可能你會有更多嘅 losses，可能你需要做更多唔同嘅cabling，more complicated。咁樣如果 more complex 咧，你嘅 operating cost 就會起啦，operating cost 起咗 value in use 就會降低啦。 第三咧就係、是、同樣一個 physical harm 啦，頭先我講 PPE 我哋已經係用咗嘅，咁呢個 physical harm 咧就會影響到佢嘅 value in use 啦，可能佢壞咗你可以修整，但係修整之後咧佢係咪同之前一樣咁勁咧？就可能係冇嘅，咁你修整過之後嘅 power plant 咧，其實基本上都係冇乜咁值錢啦，尤其係壞過嘅。如果冇壞過嘅 power plant 可能比較值錢啲。咁呢個 physical harm 咧係可能會影響到 value in use 同埋 fair value less cost of disposal 嘅。咁如果你睇下我答案咧，我係有提及到呢啲啦。有 point two 6分入邊咧，我係提及到呢三個 point 嘅，所以呢個公司咧係需要做一個 impairment test 嘅。咁佢係冇俾數字我哋啦，咁我哋就冇辦法去計算啦，究竟有冇 impairment loss 啦。但有幾個 point 其實我哋係可以提及到嘅，因為成個環境係轉變咗啦。你要去估計你嘅 fair value 咧，其實係有少少困難嘅，因為你啲 power plant 咧係屬於比較舊啲嘅科技，係用煤炭去發電嘅。咁樣如果你要賣俾翻去市場啊，賣俾你嘅對手啊，咁其實都係。可能冇咩人想要卖你嘅 power plant 嘅啦，因为比较落后啲嘅科技，同埋佢唔系咁对环境唔系咁好啊，咁可能呢个 law 咧，呢个 matter 咧，佢系唔容许你继续使用，同埋如果你嘅客户系知道你用呢啲煤炭去发电嘅，可能都唔会帮你卖电噶，咁呢个 fair value 咧可能会好低啦，但系去到几低咧，我哋系好难去估计，因为我哋冇一个实质嘅。selling price 啦，因为呢个系一个新嘅现象、新嘅环境。咁其二咧，你要估计你嘅 value in use 咧，都可能系有少少困难嘅。但佢有提及到咧，喺最尾呢一排度啊，佢系讲佢系冇 recognize 到个 impairment loss 嘅。咁我哋睇完成个情况之后咧，就觉得点解会冇 impairment loss 咧？你几乎系真系十万火急咁滞噶啦。面對咁多嘅問題，我知道你係其實係有make effort 啦，去做一啲啲嘢去修正啦，去改正呢啲問題啦。你有講你有 cutting emissions，你係要減少呢個廢氣嘅排量啦。但如果你做唔到嘅話咧，你係會流失更多嘅客户嘅。咁我睇到as at the year end 年尾，依家咁樣嘅 current condition 咁樣嘅現狀咧，你係基本上係。未做到任何嘢出嚟噶啦，咁我知道 IS 36咧，佢系需要你 when you are estimating your value in use，你系要根据 current condition，你喺今日你做咗啲乜嘢嘢？我知道你未来有好多大计，但系喺今日你有冇做到啲大计？有冇啲实质嘅嘢去证明你其实系有呢个 value in use 嘅？如果你证明唔到咧，咁根据今日现状嚟讲咧，你嘅 value in use 系。就要偏低啦，因为你真正有客户嘅流失，as a current condition，你冇咁多 sales 咗，你冇咁多 inflow 咗，咁根据 current condition 咧，其实你系需要有呢个 impairment loss 嘅，咁都会提及到啦，value in use based on current condition，虽然你有 taking measures to reduce carbon emission，但系你冇一啲实质嘅嘢俾我哋睇到，所以我哋会建议呢个公司系去。recognize 呢个 impairment loss 啦。OK，第三条问题咧，佢系提及到 provision，佢都系6分啦。咁样如果我哋翻去嗰个 CBIT 嗰度咧，我哋系可以揾到几个 point 系同 provision 有关嘅。首先嚟讲咧，佢哋好可能系需要被罚款嘅。揾呢个颜色，OK，我哋放蓝色啦。你被罚款，如果佢冇办法达到政府规定嘅标准，咁样我哋就会劝呢间公司，你系需要去睇一睇，你需要去 assess 一下，睇一睇究竟你系可唔可以达到呢个标准。如果你达唔到呢个标准咧，咁你就再去睇你有冇呢个 present obligation 去还呢个罚款。如果係有嘅話咧，你係需要recognize 一個 provision 啦，OK？但係我哋都會提及到啦，好似你想要去估計呢個 provision 嘅數額，其實可能都係唔係咁容易嘅，因為可能呢啲係啲新嘢嚟嘅，你係冇一啲 先例去參考嘅，可能你嘅 discount rate 都係有少少問題，因為個成個環境都轉變咗啦，你係需要再重新去估計你嘅 cost of equity、你嘅 cost of debt 同埋 market interest rate 去衡量一下，去決定一下究竟邊一個 discount rate 先係比較適合嘅。咁呢個係第一個 point 啦。如果你睇一睇我嘅答案嚟講咧，我係有提及到啦。If there's an actual breach，如果你達唔到個標準咧，咁你就有一個 present obligation 啦，你可能係需要去 recognize 呢個 provision 嘅。咁先頭提到嘅數額啦、discount rate 啦，我哋都可以喺呢度提及到嘅。咁另外一個 point 咧，佢就需要有 provision 嘅問題咧，就係佢提及到佢都想做一個 restructuring。咁呢個喺考試咧係非常之經常會見到噶啦。呢、这個例子，provision for restructuring。咁當佢哋要 restructuring 咧，咁佢又冇喺呢個 exhibit 度冇講得好清楚，究竟佢哋想點樣去做？但係嚟嚟去去咧，restructuring 咧都係會有類似話佢刪一啲部門啊，譬如話一啲部門係唔賺錢啊，一啲部門係達唔到呢個 green environment 嘅標準啊，咁佢哋要刪咯。喺呢個咁嘅情形，佢哋可能都需要炒一啲人啊。要賠一啲 compensation 啦，咁一啲啲product 一啲啲 services 佢哋需要暫停啊，或者係需要斬咗佢啊，咁樣可能佢哋之前買咗啲嘢俾 warranty，咁佢哋又冇辦法去完成呢個 warranty promise，咁佢又需要賠錢啊。咁如果你想要 recognize 呢個 provision for restructuring 咧，佢係需要到兩件事嘅兩點。第一咧，你係需要有個 detail plan approved by the board。單單 detail plan 都係唔夠嘅，你需要 approve by the board，咁先至冇得 U-turn 啊嘛。咁第二咧，你係需要 announce，你需要係去公布 announce the plan to the public or any parties relevant to the plan。如果你冇 announcement 嘅話咧，咁你需要做 execution，因為可能你覺得呢個 restructuring plan 唔係好大，你唔需要做 announcement，咁你直接去 implement，直接去做呢個 restructuring，咁樣都係達到。provision recognition 就標準咗噶啦，咁 detail plan approve plus announcement or execution，你係可以做呢個 restructuring provision 嘅。咁 restructuring provision 咧，佢係定係包含到direct expenditure，咁你需要賠嘅 compensation 啊嗰啲係喺入邊嘅。咁如果喺你嘅 restructuring 入邊咧，係有呢啲咁樣嘅 capital expenditure，你想加強你嘅 building 去做 green environment green building。Better for environment，咁其實呢啲係冇 present obligation 嘅，冇人去強迫你去加強你嘅 building。但如果你炒人嘅話咧，你就係有呢個義務，呢個強迫性嘅義務去賠錢俾你啲員工，咁嗰個就係 provision 啦。但呢個加強呢個 building 咧，其實咁你嘅 provision 咧，淨係可以包含 direct expenditure 啦，係唔會包含 cost relating to ongoing operation。或者一啲 voluntary expenditure 係唔係 compulsory expenditure 嘅？咁如果你聽我嘅答案嚟講咧，都係有提及到呢個啦。我哋需要 detail plan 啦，announce or execution 啦，咁 recognize direct expenditure。如果你要加多一項咧，都係可以嘅。咁我哋可以講到 ongoing expenditure 啦，OK，any plan。Expenditure, voluntary expenditure, okay, voluntary expenditure that do not create the present obligation, such as cost relating to building, okay, future building and are not to be included in the provision liability. OK，之後有第三個 point 啦，係響PPE 嗰度有提及到嘅，就係呢個 physical harm 同埋呢個 decommissioning sooner than expected。咁樣我哋就最好唔好 做一個 repetition 啦，又講翻同一樣嘢，可能我哋可以提及到，當你有呢個 decommissioning，你係需要去重新去估計啦，個數額啦、discount rate 啦，係講翻，同埋我覺得一個重點嘅就係呢個啦。咁睇嚟有一啲啲 restoration work 你係做唔到嘅，咁點解做唔到咧？佢又冇講啊，可能係 physically impossible，即係做唔到嘅嘢，就真係做唔到嘅嘢。又或者係其實做到嘅，但係公司嘅資金有限，所以暫時做唔到。咁如果做唔到，會有乜嘢效果咧？有咩副作用咧？咁可能會有 penalty 啦，from the regulator, from the government。咁樣呢啲個公司都需要去衡量一下，究竟需唔需要 recognize 一個 provision for not achieving the restoration work？咁我答案係有提到噶啦，not possible。呢個首先講嗰個 changes in the provision 啦，OK，then this is applied prospectively 喺 PPE 嗰度應該係冇提到嘅，等我睇翻下先啦。OK，應該係冇提到係 prospective adjustment 嘅。響 IAS 8入邊咧，IAS 8入邊咧，如果你 change 嘅 estimation，你重新去估計一啲啲嘢咧。你唔需要做 retrospective adjustment 嘅，你做 prospective adjustment。咁你喺 X6、X5、X4 之前用开嘅 provision 咧，你系可以唔使更改噶啦。咁喺 X7 你改呢个 provision 嗰阵时咧，你净系需要改 X7 嘅financial statement 同埋 X7 onwards 啦，prospective adjustment。咁嗰个 restoration work 你达唔到个标准咧，你可能需要 recognize 个 provision 啦。咁你需要去衡量啦，去 assess 啦，究竟有冇咁样嘅必要。咁样第四条 part 问题 part B 啊，个考官有提到一点嘅咧，我自己本身都有几有共鸣下嘅，就系佢话啲考生嘅答案系分类得唔够仔细，it doesn't have a good structure。我就覺得其實又唔可以全怪晒個考生嘅，因為你睇下個問題係咪？佢喺呢個 part B 係有分三個部分，但係咧，我哋翻翻個問題嚟睇咧，個 exhibit 咧其實係冇分呢三個部分嘅，佢係全部嘢都楞埋一齊嘅。咁樣我覺得呢個考官有少少唔係咁公平啦。如果你話個考生做咩你答案全部楞埋一齊啊？咁我哋都可以問翻你啦，點解你嘅問題全部撈埋一齊啊？你自己都冇做好個講嘅俾我哋睇，咁啲資料啊，好混亂啊，呢度一啲，嗰度一啲咁樣，其實都係唔係咁容易作答嘛，啱冇？你個 requirement 就分得靚靚喎，但係你嘅問題係冇嘅喎，所以如果我哋翻翻去呢度咧，佢就係有講提及到啦，我俾你睇下。Where is the weak student？OK，上報多少嘅？你俾啲時間我啊。讀緊啦。OK，喺呢度啊。Weaker answer presented all three issues under a single and less structured heading。咁你唔得怪佢喎，你自己嘅問題都係做到咁樣樣，咁佢你想人哋點樣咧？咁啊，某一方面有啲比較好啲嘅考生咧，就好似我咁樣啦，又有分類啦，我俾翻你睇我嘅答案啦。頭先我哋都有討論到嘅，就係啦，我哋有分噶啦，呢、这個 heading，第二個到第三個。咁樣其實真係萬大事都好啦，都係要跟住個 requirement 嚟行啦。個問題點樣問係都係其次啦，都係跟住個 requirement 啦。OK，呢個係其中一個。咁仲有另外一個咧，就係呢個應該係好普遍嘅問題啦好普遍嘅現象啦。佢哋就係冇好多考生都係冇 application 嘅，即係話嗰啲 general factor 就一流噶啦，但係點樣運用響點樣apply 落？個 scenario case 咧就做唔到噶啦，咁啊其他啲嘢咧都唔係話好多啦，因為我睇成份嘅 exam report 咧，佢就係講好多關於個問題同埋個答案，
而考生表现点样啊，佢又就系冇咩点样提及到啦。但系无论如何咧，呢一份嘅 exam report 咧都系一个好有用嘅文件啦。你其实可以花啲时间去睇下，尤其是系个 examiner 同我哋讲下点样去攞分数啊，边度可以攞到更好嘅分数啊，你其实可以睇下嘅。